Dave Chamberlain here from Next Level Outdoor Reviews. If you watch any of my review videos, you know I love products that help me succeed outdoors, whether that's hunting, camping, transportation. But I also love fishing, and fishing just gets me out there, makes me think about my childhood. A lot of good times out on the lake, in the creeks. And when you're fishing, one thing that really gives you an advantage is a good rod. A good rod can set you apart from casting and getting your line wet to feeling the sensitivity to hook a fish. Today I want to talk to you about St. Croix rods, and specifically the Triumph Salmon and Steelhead Spinning Rod. So that's what I have in front of me. I'll get it out of the plastic. We'll go over some of the features of the rod. So I got it out of the plastic. Right off the bat, these are durability sensitive with impressive power. Triumph Salmon and Steelhead rods are built for savvy anglers seeking the best in performance and value. So guys, come on in. I'll get you some close-up video of the features of the rod. So for the features, it has the premium quality SC11 carbon. It has the Sea Guide Atlas Performance Slim aluminum oxide guides with black frames. Also features the Sea Guide XDPS reel seat with eco-friendly sandblasted hoods. Has the premium cork handle. It has two coats of Flex Coat Slow Cure Finish. It has a 5-year warranty backed by St. Croix's Superstar Service. Now there are 4 salmon and steelhead spinning models available with different specs. You want to choose the right one depending on the type of fishing you are doing. This one here is a TRS-86HF2. It's an 8'6" length, heavy power, fast action. As you guys saw, it's a 2-piece rod. They're all 2-piece rods. It's suited for a 12 to 25 pound line weight and a 1/2 to 2 ounce lure weight. Overall, it weighs 6.2 ounces. Triumph is a vast, diverse series of rods that is a terrific value. So these are great rods. If you guys know anything about fishing rods or who makes the best rods, St. Croix is always at the top of the conversation. So it's one of those things where if you've never experienced one, once you do, you'll ask yourself, why'd I wait this long to get a St. Croix rod? They have tremendous value. They're not as expensive as you think they are when you look at the price points. I just encourage you guys to hop on stcroixrods.com. They have a large selection of fresh and saltwater rods, so depending what type of fishing you're doing. That website is very handy to be able to look up different things and how you can have the best advantage when you're out on the water. They'll help you select a rod. Great customer service. And on that website, you can also shop for apparel and accessories. So I can't wait to get this in my hands on the open water, do some salmon fishing. And if you've done salmon fishing, you know that a heavy rod or a rod that just isn't very easy to cast. You're thrown out there a lot of times, and you can wear yourself down pretty easy. And I'm just excited about this rod, just the way it balances out. That 6.2 ounce rod weight, it's very light. You get a reel on there, just balances so well, and the sensitivity that you'll be able to feel when a fish strikes. Really looking forward to using it. Well guys, I have a special guest with me here today, and I want to get him in front of the camera and we'll talk about the rod a little bit and just our experience with it. Guys, so I have my good friend Brian Spray here. He's done some tournament fishing, and I wanted to bring him on so he could give me a little dialogue about his first impressions on the rod and give me a little background about the fishing he does.
All right, great. Hi guys, I'm glad to be here. Thanks Dave for having me out. A little bit about me. I've been doing tournament fishing out of a kayak for a couple of years now. I mostly do bass fishing, but I do multi-species fishing as well. Loved salmon fishing as well as bass and kayak and out of the kayak. But my tournaments are really all bass fishing, both smallmouth and largemouth. And I love it, and I'm always looking for new equipment.
So. Right. So you're one of the first guys that took me on a good salmon fishing trip, so good memories. I appreciate that. We had a good time out there. And as far as salmon fishing, and you mentioned you want good equipment, tell me your first impressions on the St. Croix salmon rod here.
So if you remember right, we were up in Michigan and we were trudging along and in different spots along the river that we were on, and it's really important that you have equipment that's durable but not cumbersome either. And that's the first thing I'm noticing with this rod, is it's really light. It's not too long. You don't want a real short rod for salmon fishing, but this one's I think it said 8.6. I think it's perfect when you're trudging along the river and you're wanting to float, you're wanting to go with the current, but you're also got something that's not too heavy. And this feels really light to me, but it's a heavy power rod. So essentially what that means is, and I'll kind of bring this where you see it, when you kind of mess with the action of it, it's got action, which you got to have.
Right.
You want action. You don't want it too stiff, but it's going to be strong enough for those king salmon, coho salmon, to set the hook. And remember one thing. Here's your tip for me. Smaller the hook, the better the hook set on salmon. Right. And that may be counterintuitive to a lot of guys trying to get those big old coho salmon, but a smaller hook on a rod like this will be perfect. So, yeah, I love this thing so far. It's nice, light, got a great feel. I imagine putting a good spinning reel on there, and I love the feel of it. And you don't want anything too heavy to get tired in your hand when you're going up and down the river.
Right.
So, yep, and it's a pretty color.
Now, Brian, you touched on having good equipment, and you yourself is someone who's worked in the tackle industry and a fish and tackle shop. Tell me a little bit about the reputation that St. Croix has in your eyes.
I guarantee you, anyone that's ever went fishing, you've heard the name St. Croix at least. High quality, moderate to high-end rods all across the board. Their reputation goes without saying, I think, in bass fishing and in salmon fishing and just about any species, they provide a high-quality rod. The thing that I think of when I think of them, as I've had friends who do use St. Croix a lot, is their level of service. If you've got a problem with the rod that you buy from them, whether it maybe it breaks or it's got a defect that they didn't know, they're going to take care of you. I've heard that about St. Croix big time. The blanks they use are high quality, and I know that, and they love the craftsmanship. They really work hard on the craftsmanship to put into these rods. So the name is synonymous with quality, and that's what you're going to get. And I'm telling you, salmon fishing, you want quality. You don't want that rod snapping on you when you got that big old coho on the other end of it.
Brian, I appreciate you being here to help with the review and just give a little bit of your perspective with St. Croix and this rod in general. I know that you have a lot of knowledge. Appreciate everything you bring to the table.
Yeah.
I know you also do a video podcast. Can you tell me just a little bit about that? Some of the viewers might be interested in that.
Absolutely. So I'm part of a tournament group, mostly in Indiana, also in Illinois, called GRBY, which stands for Grassroots Bass Yakin. And I developed a podcast. It's a live video podcast that I do once a week surrounding that group. And we talk about everything fishing related, kayak fishing related, and I enjoyed it. It's called Grubby Talk, and it airs right now mostly on Tuesday nights at 7 o'clock during the season. In the off season, I do Sunday nights because our tournaments run Thursday through Monday, so by Tuesday we know who the winners are of all the tournaments we've had that particular weekend. I interview the winners, I talk a little bit about the sponsors that we have for the show, talk a lot about rods, reels, bait, talk a lot about techniques, and it's a lot of fun. So it's Grubby Talk, Tuesday, 7 o'clock.
All right, Brian. Well, I appreciate you again, and thanks for taking the time to do this. Again, I want to thank you guys for watching the review. Make sure you like and subscribe so you don't miss out any good outdoor reviews. Take care, guys.